YouTube. I thought I'd give A0 a break this week and reply to a message I received instead. Dr. Jerry, who allegedly has a PhD, has made this video, which is merely a series of denials concerning the overwhelming evidence of evolution. He routinely deletes the comments of anyone who takes the time to criticize his rants and offers nothing in the way of rebuttals but more denials. I don't make videos, but I greatly enjoyed your recent point-by-point rebuttal of a creationist video, and I'm sending you this one in the hopes that you could perform the same service for Dr. Jerry. Thank you. Sincerely, Qwaithmir. So, Qwaithmir, this one's for you.
Hi, I'm Jerry Kafitz with JerryKBooks.com, and I'm here to talk to you today about a controversy that exists in our culture and in the world, and it is the controversy of creation versus evolution.
Great, that's an excellent topic to discuss. I'm looking forward to hearing what a doctor such as yourself has to say on the topic.
How did we get here? How did the world come to be? How did the universe come to be?
Wait, what did you say?
How did we get here? How did the world come to be? How did the universe come to be?
How the Earth came to be and how the universe came to be. But that's got nothing to do with evolution. Wait a second, what type of doctor did you say you were again? Oh, right, a doctor of religious philosophy. Not science, then.
Now, first of all, I want to define for you what science is, all right? People say, well, creation's not scientific. Well, what's science? In order for something to be scientific, it has to meet two criteria. Number one, it has to be observable, or number two, it has to be reproducible in a laboratory, all right?
That's your definition of science, really? Reproducible in a laboratory? I mean, that narrows things down quite a bit, don't you think? I mean, even if we just, for argument's sake, forget all about cosmology, meteorology, geography, and just focus on biology here. Most of biology is actually done outside of the lab, in the field, you know, where the biology is. Maybe I'm being a little bit pedantic here, but just so we're clear, science, at its most basic level, is actually the collection of evidence-based knowledge in order to make correct predictions.
Now, who do you know that was around at the original creation? Me neither. I don't know anybody.
What's that got to do with evolution?
Who do you know that has been able to reproduce evolution in a laboratory? Nobody.
Really? So if I were to Google evolution in the laboratory, I wouldn't find anything. Let's just have a look, shall we? MSNBC. Scientists force evolution in the lab. February 2nd, 2006. Scientists have forced a little evolution in the laboratory, controlling whether a caterpillar becomes green or black. New Scientist. Bacteria make major evolutionary shift in the lab. 9th of June, 2008. A major evolutionary innovation has unfurled right in front of researchers' eyes. It is the first time evolution has been caught in the act of making such a rare and complex trait. And that's just the first two examples that popped up when I specifically searched for evolution happening in the laboratory. Now, if you want to have a read of those articles, I'll pop them up in the sidebar for you.
So, is evolution scientific? No, it's not.
Yes, it is, even by your extremely limited definition.
Is creation scientific? No, it's not.
Well, I'd have to agree with you 100% on that.
They're both theories.
Oh no, don't tell me you just made the same old argument that evolution is only a theory.
We used to call it the theory of evolution. So for one theory to say to another theory, you're not scientific, well, I'm sorry, that's not honest. All right?
Oh, Jerry. Are you honestly trying to tell me that you don't know the difference between a hypothesis and a scientific theory? What type of doctor do you say you were again? Oh, right. Just quickly, the term theory can have two different meanings. In layman's terms, it can mean an idea. In scientific terms, it can be the set of principles that explains natural phenomena, which is then backed up by evidence.
Here's the issue. Which body of evidence best fits the data? Okay, the evolutionists say we have this vast body of evidence that proves evolution. Well, bring out the evidence, bring out that body of data, and let people decide.
Thank you.
creationists say, we have this tremendous body of evidence, and that body of evidence proves creation. So what happens is, very often, is the proponents of one argument will try to dismiss the other argument by mischaracterizing it.
Or, you know, by pointing out the logical fallacies, contradictions, errors, and complete lack of evidence.
Right? The evolutionists have a way of dealing with this, with some of these elements of data in the body of knowledge that the creationists bring out. And by the way, there are hundreds, if not thousands, of creation scientists. They are scientists. There are hundreds and hundreds of them. They have earned degrees, master's degrees, PhDs.
Like your doctorate, for instance, which makes you an expert in evolution?
Okay. Now here's what the evolutionists do when we bring out some of these things on the creation side. They have a song that they sing, and they have a method that they use, and it involves these two fingers right here, index fingers. Here's how they do it. You bring out something they don't want to hear, and it goes, la, 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 la. Now, for those of you who may want to remember those words, I'm putting them on the screen right now so you can see it. It's a wonderful song, and it serves the purpose of people who don't want to hear some truths quite well.
Don't you think you're being a little bit childish there? Listen, dismissing a theory because it is unsupported and unfounded is not the same as simply ignoring it. But I was wondering, have you considered all the geological evidence that supports evolution?
La, 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 la.
Okay, how about all the genetic evidence?
La, 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 la.
Right, well, I can see how this is going to go.
La, 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 la.
Anyway, thanks for watching, and keep learning. Oh, and one more thing. If there's anyone else out there who would like me to make a video on their behalf, just drop me a line. Cheers.